Hey guys, it's Jack Jack and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm sharing my April favorites. Happy Friday, by the way. It is a rainy day here in San Diego, so if you hear the rain, just ignore it. Actually, no, enjoy it. If you hear the rain, just enjoy it. I'm here to share with you my favorites for the past month. I've got, you know, a few beauty things here and there, but it's mainly just like random lifestyle things. I have some movies and music and YouTubers I want to share with you guys, or like YouTube videos I want to share with you guys. So without further ado, let's just go ahead and jump on into the video. Once I find a makeup routine like that I like, I'll just stick with it and it just won't break. It won't budge, it won't break, it won't change. And for the longest time now, I have been using the Milani Conceal and Perfect foundation. This is the 2-in-1 foundation and concealer. I am in medium beige, which actually looks a little dark for me. But this is what I've been using, and it comes with a pump, but like mine is almost empty, but there's still like so much product in here, you know what I mean? So I just use this little applicator. Oh my gosh, I just put that right on my glasses. Oh my gosh. BRB, so I can go clean this. Okay, I'm back, but you get what I mean. That's how I apply it, and then I'll just use a little foundation blending brush to blend it into my skin, and I really like it. It gives you really good coverage, and your skin just looks like flawless, and it's a drugstore foundation, so like, why not, right? That's the only makeup product that I have to share with you, but I have some skincare that I wanted to share with you. A few weeks ago, Dermae did this like Zoom pajama hangout sort of thing where we got to chat with a skincare specialist, and we got to go over like kind of what the steps are, what the order is of like your nighttime skincare routine. If you want to do like an at-home spa facial night, all that kind of stuff, we went over the steps, and like Dermae sent over products for us to play with, and it was just so awesome. They gave us cute pajamas. It was amazing. I loved it. And ever since that Zoom, I've been like more excited about skincare, and so I have them like lined up in order for which like step to go through my whole night routine, and I have been loving my skincare routine. It's been like really fun and exciting for me. And one thing in particular that I wanted to share is serums. Like, I am one to like easily neglect serums. Like, I could care less. If you ask me to write up a skincare regimen for you, I'll probably skip out on serums because it's just something I don't think twice about, like ever. But I've been using, I use this for my morning skincare routine, and then I have a different one for night. But the morning one, I use the Dermae Blue Light Shield Concentrated Serum. And I know that serums are better than like moisturizer and stuff like that because they penetrate the skin deeper. So if you have a specific concern with your skin needs, serums are great to use. But I like this blue light serum because it helps to protect your skin from, you know, the blue light from your phone, from your computer. And you guys know me, I'm on my phone and computer literally all day long. So I have it with my glasses, which that's why I like wearing my glasses when I'm like editing and stuff. And now I have it in my skincare. It's one of those things where I can't like tell you if it's working. I can't show you if it's working, but it's like just one of those things, like kind of like, let me think of a good example. I don't know, like having an insurance, you don't always use it, but it's nice to know that it's there if you do need it. Does that make, like, I don't notice this, but it's nice to know that it's there. That's probably a stupid example. Better to be safe than sorry, I suppose, right? And the moisturizer I've been loving, like this is also really exciting because before the Zoom call with Dermae and before getting like re-inspired with my whole skincare routine, I would be so lazy with my skincare routine, and literally I'll wash my face and only use a facial oil and that is it. I wouldn't even bother with anything else. But you know, I'm excited about my skincare now, so I've added moisturizer, and I've been using the Dermae Ultra Lift Firming DMAE Moisturizer. This is the one like everyone in the Zoom call was raving about. If you have dry skin, this is the one you want. The Ultra Lift Firming DMAE Moisturizer. If you have aging dry skin, this is the moisturizer you want. You guys know aging, wrinkles, all that kind of stuff is definitely my biggest skincare concern. So love having this, and they were all just like raving about it, but I just love how thick it is. If you don't like thick moisturizers, just pass on this. But if you have dry skin, you probably like thick moisturizers. This just feels so good at the end of the night. I just feel like I have this like pillow blanket moisturizer just laying on my face as I go to sleep. I don't know, it's the best feeling. My skin just feels really, really nice. And I don't know, I love a good thick moisturizer. My skin is dry as a desert, so I appreciate that. And if it helps with lifting and firming, go ahead, I ain't stopping it. Go ahead, do your thing. I am not against anything to help lift and firm. Okay, that was all like the beauty related things, I suppose. Oh, I have a hair tie I want to share with you guys. Probably so random, but look at how cute this little hair tie is. Wait, did I share this in my last favorites? I found this at Target. This is from Christine S. And it's, okay, so this is the hair tie part right here, a little regular scrunchie. But then you have this ribbon here where you can tie into a cute little bow. I double knotted it so it won't like move, but how stinking cute is that? You just put it in your hair. Well, normally when you have like a ponytail, I mean, you could put it like this too. Like if we styled this, we could make it look like that in our little bun. That's kind of cute too. But I just think this is so fun. It just kind of enhances a basic ponytail. And I love this color. This color is so awesome. What would you call it? Like a coppery reddish brown, like orangey brown. I like this color. It's awesome. I know this color like screams fall, and so does this shirt too. But you know what? I love these colors all year long. My next favorite is a planner that I want to share with you guys. I've been using this for the past like maybe 2 months now. I don't know how long it's been, but I love this and I don't even use it as a planner. So I'm excited to share it with you. But this is the Erin Condren Focused Pocket Planner. Look at how tiny and cute it is. I love a good tiny planner. It's like, it's so adorable. This color is delicious. Goes kind of with that hair tie. This color is amazing. But this is just a cute little horizontal planner. You know, you got your monthly, which I don't use the monthly. You've got a dashboard in here too, which I also don't use the dashboard. But this is what the weekly pages look like. It's just a basic horizontal, right? But I use it as a little daily diary. So I'll put just, I don't want to show you my diary because this is the internet, you know? But I'll just do a little tiny passage each day, kind of remembering, you know, how the day went, whatever it may be. Here, I'll read some that are not so embarrassing. February 18th, had canes for the first time, still getting used to chicken texture, but it was good. We'll eat again. I don't think I've eaten again since then, to be honest. I don't think I have. April 6th, can't seem to get any work done. I'm kind of overwhelmed and such a hot mess. Send help. Oh my gosh, Sunday, April 10th. Ugh, pizza is life. Papa John's. That's all I put for Sunday. So I just write in here every day. I usually like to write in the mornings. So like I'll write what happened the previous day. I just think it's the perfect size for a little diary. I love this and it is so, so cute. I'm obsessed with this. My little daily diary. Do you hear the rain picking up? I love the sound of rain. Oh my gosh, I am surprised that I'm having a productive work day because the rain just makes me so lazy, as well as I'm sure a lot of people, like, doesn't it just make you want to curl up with a good book inside? What is that thing that Phyllis always says?
I mean, normally the rain would make me want to stay at home curled up with a good book.
My next favorite, we're going to feature a plant because you guys know I love talking about my plant babies. So we are going to talk about Miss Charlotte. My very, very first plant. So she's extra special because, I mean, I haven't been into plants very long. I would say maybe the past 6-7 months, maybe, I've been into plants. And Charlotte, she's a spider plant. She was my very, very first one. And I love her. She's so easy to take care of. She's not high maintenance. I barely have to water her. Once or twice a month, honestly, and she's good. And she's still, look at her, she's still thriving. But recently, and I shared this in my vlogs, I'll leave it linked in the cards if you guys want to check it out, but I recently propagated her for the first time, and just look at those roots growing. Like, that's like maybe 2 weeks of growth right there in the water. Like, she just grows so fast. I'm so impressed by her. And she's just so pretty. I love plants that are lush. I'm not a succulent kind of girl. I don't like succulents. I don't like to care for succulents. I don't even like the way succulents look. I don't like succulents. But these lush, green, just wild plants, I love. They're my favorite kind. And Charlotte was definitely a great first pick plant, a perfect little intro into the plant world. She's just so easy to care for. Look, this is where she was growing all those spider babies. She's just awesome, literally so awesome. And I just keep her in a basket. Yeah, you can put your plants in a basket. Look, this is from TJ Maxx for $7.99. Isn't that just a cute basket? I just tucked in the little handles and whoopsie. And yeah, there you go. Just plop her in and she's good. Doesn't that look cute? So cute. I love Charlotte. She is the best. She is such a great gal, you know? Gotta love Charlotte. Okay, I have a new obsession. Which is funny because I don't really cook often, especially now because I've been balancing a new buttload of work. And so I especially don't really cook even more so now because of that. So I don't know why I've been into this, but I love watching cooking videos. And I go through phases of who I like watching. Like sometimes I'll be super into like the Food Network, watching all those cooking shows. But as of right now, I've been super into two in particular, and I want to share them with you guys. The first one is Florence Pugh. Is that how you say her last name? She's an actress and she shares on her Instagram stories lots of different cooking related stuff, and people will, I don't know if this is her or just like fans, but they'll post the stories of her cooking on YouTube, and I've just been watching so many of those. I love watching her cook. First of all, she's a great actress. Second of all, she is just so funny and awesome. I love listening to her talk. She has the best accent ever, and I like seeing the things she eats because it's so different from, you know, the junk that I eat. So I feel really inspired when I watch her videos. She also played Amy in Little Women, which I'm still obsessed with. That's still a forever favorite. I love Little Women so much. I love Little Women so much. The movie, amazing. The film score, amazing. I just love it. But going back to cooking, another one, this is actually a YouTuber. The channel is called French Cooking Academy, and I've been watching a lot of his videos. I'm just so fascinated with how other people cook. Like, I've seen, you know, American cooking, I've seen, you know, Asian cooking from my mom, or I've seen Mexican cooking from Johnny's family, but never like English or French. And I've just been so fascinated by it, and I want to try all the recipes. Like, I want to taste what their flavor palette is like, because it's so different from like the junk here that I eat on a normal daily basis. I highly recommend you check out both of those, Florence Pugh and French Cooking Academy. Go check them out for some cooking inspiration. I think you'll have a lot of fun, because I have a lot of fun watching them. So hopefully you will too. Going back to movies, I have one. I'm kind of embarrassed to say that I have just now watched it, but because I did theater growing up, so this is like embarrassing that I would say this now, but I finally watched Into the Woods, the one that's on Disney Plus, with Anna Kendrick, James, what's the talk show guy? I don't even know his name. Emily Blunt. Who else is in there? There's a lot of people in there. Oh my gosh, the little boy from Les Mis.
I do you too, my name's Gavroche.
Such a little cutie. But I finally watched it on Disney Plus. And I loved it. I mean, I knew the story already, again, from theater. But I haven't seen that rendition of it, I guess. I haven't seen that movie. So I was happy I finally watched it. I thought it was really good. And so there's that. If you haven't watched it on Disney Plus, highly recommend it. So I mentioned how the Little Women film score is just amazing, and I think I even mentioned it in my last favorites because I just love it so much. But there's a specific playlist on Spotify that I've been having on repeat lately. It's the Dark Academia playlist on Spotify. It's so beautiful. I play it like right when I wake up, like while I'm reading the Bible, I'll listen to it, and it's just so beautiful. I desperately want to learn to play the piano. First, I need to get a piano, and then I will learn, because I just love listening to the piano. And then another album that I wanted to share with you guys, I might have already shared this before, who cares, I'm sharing it again, but it's, is it River and Robots, or Robots and River? No, River and Robots. They have an album called Discover. I think it's called Discover, but that is such a beautiful, chill, like, relaxed very cool kind of vibe. I just listen to it and imagine like roller skating on the beach, or like, you know, on the little sidewalk on Mission Beach. Like, I just, it's skating music. To me, it's like skating music, and it's Christian, so it's like I'm worshiping and skating at the same time. Like, it just, it's a good time. It's a good time. I haven't skated recently, but I hope to go skating and listen to this album while I skate. So anyways, that is it for my favorites video. That is my random collection of things that I've been liking for the past month. Let me know in the comments what your favorites have been for April, and I will see you guys in the next video.